Has Taylor Swift ever appeared in a movie? How many species went extinct in 2024? Who is the most prolific movie director in India? One answer to all these questions used to be Google it. But lately, many people have ditched search engines to instead ask a chatbot like Perplexity, Gemini, or ChatGPT. If you did use a search engine like Google or Bing, have you ever wondered how the answer would be different? Let's do a test. I'll ask ChatGPT, what is the death toll of the war in Ukraine? Unlike Google or Bing, which are search engines, ChatGPT gives its answer in complete sentences. First, it qualifies its results by saying that there is no authoritative full tally. It then provides a number of Ukrainian civilian deaths. It links to three sources, a UN agency website, and two articles from Wikipedia, a free collaborative online encyclopedia. It offers up two more numbers, from the New York Post, citing a document shared by Kiev officials, and a Reuters article. ChatGPT then gives figures for Ukrainian military deaths, citing a UK government document which itself cites at least five different sources, and Wikipedia. For Russian soldiers killed, the chatbot cites two articles from the Moscow Times and Wikipedia. It then gives caveats, specifying, for example, that death tolls only include those killed and not the missing or wounded, and cites Wikipedia. In all, I counted six sources cited in ChatGPT's answer, with three of them accounting for about 80% of the answer. Now let's try a search engine. The results are displayed mostly as a list of sources with occasional suggestions for other queries. The top result is the same Wikipedia article cited several times by ChatGPT. The second is a US government report from 2023, then a Guardian article that focuses on Russia's staggering 1 million casualties. If you keep scrolling, you can see the next four sources are French and Russian media, a statistics firm, and the same OHCHR website cited by ChatGPT, all articles from the last 3 months. On the first page, you have 18 different sources. Then it's up to me to decide which link I want to click on to get more information. These outcomes are so different because the tools work differently. A chatbot like ChatGPT is a conversational robot based on a large language model, or LLM. LLMs use huge amounts of online content to detect patterns in language that allow them to predict the answer to a question or prompt and express it in conversational language. A search engine is more like a librarian. We give it keywords, and it presents us with a selection of sources that might answer our question. But then, it's up to us to choose the right ones. So, should we go with a chatbot or a search engine? Approaching the question directly from the sources via the search engine takes longer, and it requires you to be somewhat organized. ChatGPT automatically broke down its answer into categories: civilian, military, Russian, and Ukrainian. Most of the sources proposed by Google take on just one of these aspects. So to get a clear picture, you would need to analyze the results yourself. But this has its advantages. The most obvious advantage is that by accessing a statistic via its original source, you can take into account whether or how it may be biased. The other major advantage of search engines is their fine-grained search tools. Using advanced search, you can narrow results by date, location, language, and more. Some search engines even allow you to use linguistic shortcuts called search operators. Using cite colon lets you dig into specific websites. Quotation marks give you answers that include specific words in a specific order, and so on. Statistics like war casualties or even protest turnouts are highly politicized numbers, so who reports them can say a lot about their potential accuracy. When looking for high-stakes information, in the case of a conflict or an election, for example, it's key to know your sources and to have access to as many as possible. Learn more search techniques in our tutorials and with AFP's online courses.